If you're looking for dolphins videos, you might be in the right place. If you're looking for the fish that swim in the ocean, you're not in the right place. If you're looking for the latest news and rumors around your Miami Dolphins, yes, you've come to the right place. On today's show, we're going to break down some news and rumors around, I know, Deshaun Watson, but we got to keep you guys updated. I'm going to talk to you about Tua, and at the very, very end of this video, talk about a fun little NFL draft rumor that's popping up, and well, they did go out and get a new offensive line coach. But let's get into today's show around Deshaun Watson. So we've been trying to keep you guys updated on not just like the big updates around Watson, but also basically even the little ones as well. So if you watched yesterday's show, we talked about how, again, there is growing sense that he's not going to end up going back to Houston. That right now the Dolphins and the Jets, they're the front runners. Obviously, there's going to be a bunch of football teams interested in having one of the best young quarterbacks play for them. However, when you look at the latest odds on what teams could be the top suitors for him, right now the Miami Dolphins have the best odds to go out and make the trade for him. Why is that? You're looking at draft capital, you look at they have the number three pick, and they have the money to be able to do it. So it's whether or not Miami wants to do it, whether or not the Houston Texans want to be able to do it. When I made a video on our main chat sports channel, which has 230,000 subs on it, I actually also had the Miami Dolphins as the number one contender to go out and make the move. But you obviously also have to talk about Tua. And with the news that came out today around him was this. So obviously with everyone linked to Watson and the Dolphins, all eyes are on Tua now. And the report was this, that Houston doesn't believe Tua is an adequate replacement for Deshaun Watson. This, which honestly could be a deal breaker for the Texans, and it could be a deal breaker if Miami did want to actually try to go out and get quarterback Deshaun Watson. My only point is this. I saw the report and I laughed out loud for the simple fact of, if you're looking for an adequate replacement for Deshaun Watson, good luck trying to find him. Am I the biggest Tua believer? No, I am not. But Tua is a good quarterback. I just don't know if he's ever going to be a top 10 quarterback. I know some of y'all have hated on me for saying that in the past, but I do this show to be honest with you. But before I get into some of these other top quarterbacks, I do want to say this. Seriously, hit the big red button that says subscribe. We're trying to pump out more content for y'all here on this channel. Over 10,000 subscribers. And if you find yourself looking for more Dolphins news and rumors, we got you covered. Maybe more stuff around the draft. It's coming up here in a little bit, but also on this show. Free agency, trades, we got it all for you. Don't miss it. And also this, man. I've been watching a lot more Game of Thrones. I don't know if you guys like the show. You can type Game of Thrones, G-O-T in the comment section. Obviously, I'm not quite with it. But it's all about conquering. And right now you can see the Dolphins show is at 10,300 subs when you look at all these other channels here by Chat Sports. I want to catch Detroit Lions talk here, 11,500 subs. Let's beat him to 12,000. If y'all can do that, I think that would be a major win. And the next is the Chiefs report, and next is Eagles now. You guys have been doing a great job. Continue to spread the word and subscribe. YouTube.com/Dolphins News. All right, let's get back into some of this Tua versus Deshaun Watson talk. Obviously, these are the numbers that he had in 2020 in 10 games. 1,814 yards, 11 touchdowns, 5 interceptions. I am a person that was hoping for a little bit more mobility from him. However, he was coming off an injury. But back to the talk of Tua isn't an adequate replacement for Deshaun Watson. My answer to that is this. No shit. And the reason why I say that is because it's not a rip on Tua. It's just I have very, very high aspirations for a young quarterback in Deshaun Watson who led the NFL this year in passing yards. Not only is he a great passer, he can also run with the football. So when I go and I honestly look at some teams that were some quarterbacks that would be adequate replacements, there's only a few names that honestly really, really pop up for me. So what I want you guys to do is this. Let me know in the comment section, how good is Tua on a scale from 0 to 100? Because when I threw out a trade idea for y'all yesterday, I know a lot of people didn't really like it. I don't know if I personally would have done it. I've kind of gone back and forth, but I am curious. How good do y'all think Tua is from a scale from 0 to 100? All right, so here are my best quarterbacks in the National Football League right now. The reason why I was laughing is because if you're looking to get somebody better than Deshaun Watson, these guys, it's just simply not going to happen. And for Houston, you have right now probably the second best quarterback at 25 or under on your current roster. So you're not just going to go out and try to, I think, find any type of quarterback whatsoever. You should probably go out and try to find somebody that is just a little bit younger. So what I wanted to be able to do to y'all is this. Here are the best quarterbacks under 25. Here they are. Patrick Mahomes, number one. Deshaun, two. Allen, Lamar, and then Kyler Murray. Josh Allen's not getting traded. Lamar Jackson's not getting traded. And Kyler Murray. None of these players are getting traded whatsoever. But for Miami, you have a lot of draft capital. Maybe, and just maybe, if you throw some of those higher picks with a quarterback like Tua, I personally think that Houston should honestly look into this ultimately. So here's some AFC championship games we got going down. Plus, I'll get into the NFC game here in a little bit. But before I tell you what games I'm going to be betting on, I do want to give you the over-under. So Buffalo, 54 over-under. In this one, the Chiefs, they're the favorites, -3. This game is on Sunday at 6:40 p.m. Eastern time, so make sure you guys are watching. The other game, this is the earlier game, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers are going to Green Bay. I'll tell you what, if Green Bay can avenge their 38-10 loss, that would be pretty awesome, I personally think. And last time they went to Tampa Bay, they got absolutely whooped. This time, if they win, they're going to go to Tampa Bay, but it's going to be for the Super Bowl. 51.5 is the over-under in this one. Packers favorites by -3.5. If you want to bet on any of these games, you can do it at our sportsbook partner. You got to go to chatsports.com/bet. Use this promo code right here, Dolphins125. It's going to get you 125%. Deposit bonus. Had a little Coke before I came on the show. You know, the Coca-Cola and bourbon a little bit. So chatsports.com/bet. That deposit bonus is the best on the internet. So if you're curious about what are my bets this week, here they are. I got the Packers covering -3.5. I'm going to go with the over 51.5 in the game. The Bills, I have them outright beating the Chiefs. Yes, covering that +3 spread. And I'm actually going to go the under 54 points. If you guys want to disagree with me, hey, let me know down there in the comments. If you want to bet on who's going to win the Super Bowl outright, Chiefs +190. Packers, Bills, Buccaneers. I put my money on the Bills 2 days ago. And I'm hoping that I can ride this one out and come away with a win. Though, I am a little bit nervous about that Bills and Chiefs game, but I bet on the Bills. If you guys want to bet, again, it's chatsports.com/bet. Promo code Dolphins125. Speaking of Super Bowl, with Deshaun Watson, is Miami a Super Bowl contender? And I want you to be honest with me, okay? Be honest. Type T for true, or go down in the comments section and type F for false. I am going to type my T for true, and it's one of the reasons why I've been pounding my fist on the table. Can you hear it? That the Dolphins should go out and get Deshaun Watson, because the only way you're going to be able to compete with Josh Allen, the only way you're going to be able to compete with a quarterback like Patrick Mahomes, is if you go out and get another dominant quarterback in Deshaun Watson. What's been one of the biggest issues for Miami? Their offensive line. You can basically erase all your offensive line issues with him because, well, he's done a phenomenal job with a horrible Houston offensive line. You have the defense. You have the skill position players. You have a solid running game. All you're really lacking is a star quarterback. You go out and make that move. You bring in Watson to be able to put him on your team. And, I mean, as much as I love all these extra draft picks that the Dolphins have they really done a very good job last year or the last 2 years with them? No, they really haven't. No Igbinoghi, total bust this past year. Jackson, he did an okay job. But when I really go back and I look at some of these picks, I don't know. You can give me a slam dunk Super Bowl contender, get Deshaun Watson. Hey, I'm all for it. So I am on the train that the Dolphins should figure out a way to make a move for Deshaun. Speaking of the draft, let's get into this fun little draft room here. There was a report that came out that Miami could trade down in the first round. For those of you who are like, really? Wow, that surprises me. It shouldn't. The Dolphins have traded down 8 times in the first round in franchise history. And with 2 first round picks at number 3 and number 18, plus they have picked 36 and 50 in the second round, if somebody's willing to trade up and go grab a quarterback, like, I don't know, maybe Justin Fields goes 2. Obviously, Trevor Lawrence is going to go 1. If somebody wants Zach Wilson and they're willing to trade up and give you, I don't know, let's say like the 5th or 6th pick overall, and then they throw in another first because they need that quarterback, Miami should 100% go out and do that. Now, if Penei Sewell's sitting there at 3, I might have something other to say because that's the guy I really want the Dolphins to get. But if they trade down, it's never a bad thing. I am always team trade down. So go ahead. Y for yes, N for no. Let us know. That's what we do here at Chat Sports. Should the Miami Dolphins trade down in the first round of the 2021 NFL Draft? All right, we got one more update here, and then I'm going to send off for today. The Dolphins, they fired Steve Marshall on Tuesday, and then they promoted Lemuel Jeanpierre to the new offensive line coach. When I look at what Jeanpierre is going to be able to bring, he's going to bring, I think, a lot more accountability. The biggest weakness for this Dolphins offense, and I'll say it's kind of been this way for the last 3 years, has probably been the offensive line play. It's just been an absolute open door, and if you really do want to stick with Tua, you need to be able to protect him a little bit better. So he's coached with the Seahawks, he's coached with the Raiders, and he's been with the Dolphins the last few years. This is going to be a good opportunity for him, and it's a real tough job because the Dolphins still do lack, I'll say, adequate starters at the offensive line position. There's some other good players out there in the draft. There's some good guys in free agency as well. But for Jeanpierre, he needs to really step it up here. So go ahead, if you made it this far in the video, y'all, I would appreciate it. Go ahead, subscribe to our channel. Let's catch the Detroit Lions talk. We're at about 10,300 subs. Let's beat them to 12,000. I know you can do it.